Around you. Look around you. Have you figured out what it is we are looking for? If you thought linear algebra, you would be correct. Have you ever heard of a matrix? No, not that kind of matrix. A matrix is a rectangular array of elements, arranged in rows and columns, that may be manipulated according to the rules of algebra. Imagine we have a hawk and a dove. Imagine the hawk and the dove both want a particular resource. Now, imagine two hawks, and then imagine two doves. These pairs of contestants will each compete for the resource. We can display the probability of each competitor receiving some, all, or none of that resource using a matrix. When two hawks compete, one of the hawks will receive 1/2, open parentheses, V minus C, close parentheses, where V is a numerical value of the resource, and C is an associated cost. When a hawk and a dove compete, the hawk will receive V, and the dove will receive nothing. When two doves compete, they will always share the resource evenly, V divided by 2. If we want to examine each event individually, we can create a permutation matrix using every situation's unique probability. Here's the permutation matrix for a hawk versus hawk encounter. If we multiply the original matrix by this permutation matrix using matrix multiplication, we can see how the probability of a hawk versus hawk encounter would change. Now, the probability for the winning hawk after a second encounter will be 1/4, open parentheses, V minus C, close parentheses, squared. Scenario 1. Hawk versus hawk. Watch as the two fierce hawks approach one another to compete for this resource. The hawks approach, compete, and one walks away victoriously. Here is the mathematical explanation of what just happened. This hawk has defeated this hawk. However, we must not forget the associated cost. This hawk has hurt his arm and his wing. How sad. Scenario 2. Hawk versus dove. Here we have a submissive dove and a feisty hawk. They compete for this resource, approach, and the hawk emerges victoriously. In these encounters, the hawk will always gain the full resource V, and the dove will always receive nothing. Scenario 3. Dove versus dove. Here we have two equally passive doves competing for this resource. They approach each other and decide to split the resource equally. Here is what just happened mathematically. If the doves enjoyed sharing their resource so much that they decide to compete again, the multiplication of the permutation matrix for this situation with the original model yields a new probability of V squared divided by 4. A new contestant, the retaliator, could be represented in nature by a pheasant. This retaliator will display unless its opponent attacks, in which case the retaliator will strike back. Now, our model is a 3x3 matrix, with a row and column each for hawk, dove, and retaliator. Our new model still encompasses the old matrix, but now we can see that in hawk versus retaliator situations, either a hawk or a retaliator will receive 1/2 open parentheses, V minus C, close parentheses, and in dove versus retaliator situations, as well as retaliator versus retaliator situations, both contestants will split the resource equally. Scenario 4. Retaliator versus dove. Here, we have a pheasant, our retaliator, and a passive dove competing for this resource. They approach. And while at first they might appear to disagree, they will split the resource 1/2, or V divided by 2. Maybe our pheasant will give the dove his half later. Scenario 5. Retaliator versus Hawk. Here, we have a very fancy pheasant, our retaliator, and a spirited hawk. Approach the resource and begin to compete. This time, the hawk receives the resource, leaving the pheasant with nothing. Yet the hawk still displays a cost. He now walks with a limp. Thank you for joining us today for an adventure in linear algebra. Join us next week for another special edition of Look Around You. What you want, but if you try sometimes, well, you might find. Get my fair share of abuse. Singing words gonna vent our frustration. If we don't, we're gonna blow a 50-amp fuse. Sing it to me.